I want to make this video to explain to the people at Adobe Corporation that they're taking away transitions and filters that were in Premiere Pro CS 5.5, and I have no clue why they're doing it. A lot of people actually use those filters and transitions that they're actually taking away. The best filter that they ever had was the older chromakey filter. And I want people to see exactly what I'm doing here. I'm trying to get that Pleasantville effect that a lot of people like to use. And I'm going to actually get rid of this top layer. It's hidden. So you see the bottom layer. Through all these layers, you're seeing just strictly black and white on this image because I've drained it to black and white. On how you get that Pleasantville effect, obviously, is if you use a chroma key filter like blue, it knocks out the blue sky, and underneath, as everybody knows, it's black and white. That's how you get the black and white images coming through, along with the colored images coming through. I can also chroma key out the red right here, and so that actually turns to black and white. And some people might say, wow, that's cool, that's how you get the Pleasantville effect, but there's actually something kind of cool that you can actually do that's a little bit better than just using the chroma key filter, and that's by alpha adjust. If you go into alpha adjust, it'll actually take only, like right now, just the yellow one is highlighted. So instead of actually chroma keying out the yellow as you've seen before, it actually just leaves in the yellow, and then you can bring in the blue, and then you can later bring in the red, and that would be the easier way to do the Pleasantville effect by having this alpha adjust. I hope people can understand exactly what I'm saying. If I get rid of the alpha adjust, I'll do it just reverse. See, it's chroma keying out things. Without the alpha adjust, it's just going to actually drain to black and white what color you select. And you could kind of do the Pleasantville this way. It's probably not the best way to do it, though. Like I said, you'd be a lot better off using the alpha adjust in the invert alpha. Because now all you got to do is when you, like in a picture like Pleasantville, they'd have somebody maybe with a yellow purse and a yellow jacket. So they could really just concentrate on that color. Bam, that particular shade of yellow comes through. Then they can maybe concentrate on somebody with a blue coat or a blue car, and then gradually bring them all in. This is the better way to actually do it, to have the alpha adjust capability. It's a lot better than actually just chroma keying out colors. It's better if you can select a specific color. Now, if we come over here, and I want people to realize, here we have the ultra key, and I also have the alpha adjust. But if we use the ultra key, and then I try and use the alpha adjust, see how the image just like solarizes or whatever? It doesn't work the way it's supposed to. We can actually use the ultra key, hit the adjust. See, it just, no matter what color you pick out, it just doesn't work the way it's supposed to. It just drains everything to black and white, like it takes everything from the lower image. Now, like I said, with Premiere Pro Creative Cloud, they've taken out the chroma key filter, but they left the color key in, which I don't know why they would leave the color key in, because it doesn't have as much control as the old school chroma key. This old school chroma key was great. It had similarity, blend, threshold, and cutoff. And if your chroma key background doesn't act, your green screen doesn't have to be lit 100% perfect for this to be really effective. It's really easy to use, whereas the ultra key is kind of a pain in the butt. With the old school chroma key filter, you could pretty much just hit anywhere on the green screen, and it would usually work decent as long as it's lit. Halfway is decent. Doesn't have to be perfect, and that's what I'm all for, is just saving time. The ultra key is kind of a pain. Yes, you could pull off better keys with it if you really monkey around with it, but I don't know of too many people that really want to do all that, because you do have a lot of with the ultra key, things that you can adjust to make it come out a little bit better. I mean, if you start pulling these down for the ultra key, yeah, you can actually use like the pedestal, the tolerance. You can actually use midpoint, desaturate, range, spill, and all this. And it is kind of pain in the Luma too, and actually pull off a really good key that you couldn't pull off with the regular chroma key filter. But most of the chroma key, you know, work, you'll be able to use just the old school chroma key. They don't have it working with the Mercury playback engine, and maybe that's why they got rid of it, but they need to find something that's going to be as easy to use as the old chroma key filter and actually work with the alpha adjust filter. I'm just going to show the old school chroma key filter real quick. As you can see, it knocks that out pretty darn good, right? With just one click, it knocks that out pretty good. You have your similarity filter that you can go in and tweak it out with, as well as the blend mode, and really pull it off really quick. The same can be said about these yellow flowers, whatever they are. I don't know if they're orchids or what, but you can see it pulls it off pretty good. I'm going to actually turn this off, and I'm actually going to go into the alter key. I'm going to use one of the alter key filters. I'm going to actually turn it on. And when I try and knock out, you know, just the yellow, you get the highlight of the yellow still coming through. It just doesn't work as good. If I actually try and just chroma key out that red, see how it, by default it doesn't do a good job. You can go in here and manipulate it and finally get it to work.